Hello everyone, it's GELINDIGKEIT here, and I'm here with a new exciting video. So for this video, I'm going to talk about how to decorate your phone using the new iPhone update, iOS 14. I'm pretty sure a lot of you guys are confused about what is this widget thing going on and how is everyone decorating their phone so aesthetically. So I'm going to teach you how to do that. So yeah, let's get started. So first of all, I'm going to talk about the basic widget features. Your home screen is probably going to look the same unless you touch anything after the update. So if you swipe left, you'll be able to see a bunch of like widgets going on or not, depending on what apps you have. You'll probably have different widgets than me. And then if you swipe to the right, there's this thing called app library. So first of all, the basic widgets. So you tap edit, and then you click the plus icon on the top, and then you'll be able to see a bunch of different tools right here. You can add your screen time widget, photos widget, maps widget, calendar widget, or whatever kind of app you want. Let's say you want to add batteries so that you can see your batteries all the time. So for widgets, there are three sizes: small, medium, and large. So let's go for small. Add a widget. So if you add it, this widget is going to stay over here. Or what you can do is just press the home screen. You'll see the plus sign again on the top, and then you'll have the same feature that you saw. So you can either choose to add it on the certain page or just keep it on the left side. Let me add a clock now. Add a widget. So I have a clock. Basically, because I have a clock widget right here, I don't want the clock app on my phone anymore. Let's say that I don't want it anymore. Then what I can do is I click on the clock app that I have, and then edit home screen and click it. Then you're gonna click remove from home screen. But don't worry, because this is not deleting the app forever. Like I said, there's this app library on the right, and you'll be able to see the clock app still in the library. So basically, app library is like keeping all of the apps depending on their category, but you're not like deleting them forever. They're just like storaged in the app library. So I saw that some people, they just like moved all their apps into the app library and they just decorated their home screen with like pictures and those calendars, but you can do that as well, or you can keep some apps or not like me. So yeah, that's what you can do. There's basically three things added to my phone. First one is the photo widget, and the second one is the reminder on the top, and then the third one is those different icons for the apps I have. Yeah, so I'm gonna take you through three of those. So the first one, let's go through the photo. How to add photo widgets on your phone. So if you want a photo widget on your background, you have to go to App Store, and then you have to download this thing called widgetsmith. This app right here on the top. I realized that a lot of people use photo widget, but I'm not going to talk about photo widget because compared to widgetsmith, photo widget doesn't have a lot of tools, and I think they're kind of limited. So I'm just going to talk about widgetsmith for this video. So I opened widgetsmith. So I have a bunch of small widgets, and I have a medium widget as well, but I don't think you guys will have it. So I will take you through how to do this. So you click the add small widget, or if you already have like a default widget, then you can click that and then press the default widget. And now here you have so many options. You can actually add this month and date widget or this clock widget, depending on what you want. You can click anything. The ones with the locked icon, they're not free, so I don't want to use that. Alright, so I'm gonna click on photo because I want photo widget, right? And then I click select the photo, and then let's say I want this cute rabbit picture as a photo widget, and then I go to that. And then I'll just rename it. You don't have to rename it, but I like to rename it because it gets confused when a bunch of, you know, names are on the list. I'll just say cute rabbits. Oh my gosh, I can't even spell rabbits. All right, so cute rabbits is now on the list. And what I can do now is I go to the page that I want to add this cute photo of the rabbits. So I press it, I click the plus. If I scroll down, you'll be able to see widgetsmith, small widget right here. And then because I made it to a small widget, the cute rabbit photo, I'm gonna add this small one. The reason why I don't have the cute rabbit right now is because I have a bunch of small widget. You saw it, like I have different photos for the small widget. So I'm gonna click that, edit widget, go to the small one, and now I'm gonna select cute rabbits. And voila, cute rabbit photos right here. This is how you add photos. If you want a photo with a medium size, then you go into medium and do the exact same thing. If you want to go to the large one, go to large and do the exact same thing. Not only you can add photos, but you can also add calendars and clocks, like I said with widgetsmith. Let's say I want to add a medium size clock. I'm going to go to widgetsmith, add medium widget. It's going to give me like a random widget all the time. So I go to default widget to edit that. And then I want time. So I click time, and here there are so many options you can do. You can actually choose the location. You can actually choose the font. I'm gonna go for the simple one. And then the color of the writing. I'm gonna go for white. And then the color of the background as well. So there are so many options. I'm gonna go for cream, let's say. Yeah, I'm gonna do that. And I am going to say, cream colored time. So that's what I have as my second medium widget. And then what I can do is press it again, click the plus, scroll down, widgetsmith. I am going to select medium because I made the time thing as the medium widget, and then add a widget. But look, it gave me the first widget. So remember, you have to do the edit widget, go to medium, and click the cream colored time, and it's gonna give you this thing that you made. Alright, so that was it for adding photo slash schedule slash so many widgets with widgetsmith. And now I'm gonna take you through how I added this reminders widget right here. For this one, you need Reminders app. You might have it already or you might not, so make sure you have that on your phone. All right, so open the Reminders app and you'll see this home screen. You click Add List on the bottom right, and then you'll be able to see this. You might not be able to see the symbols right here. If you don't see the symbols, go to Settings, click the top button where your name and Apple ID, iCloud, this thing is. And then click iCloud. Make sure the reminders is on. If it's not on, I'm pretty sure it's not gonna show the symbol, so make sure it's on. And if you still don't see the symbols, make sure you update the app reminders. After you do all that, you'll see colors and so many symbols you can use. So let's say I want my reminders button to be sky blue. And then there's actually this emoji option as well. So you can choose an emoji that you want as like a symbol, picture of this cat. All right, now I'm just gonna name it whatever. Let's say I name it as my schedule. All right, and then I click that, and then now I'm gonna click new reminder, and then I just, you know, write whatever I want. If you want like motivational quotes, if you want to see like motivational quotes all the time you open your phone, then add motivational quotes. If you want to use it as like a to-do list, add to-do list. So this time I'm gonna use it as a to-do list. Let's say, I don't know, go grocery shopping, clean my room, go for a walk. All right, say done, go to the home screen. So again, press it, click plus, you're gonna add reminders right here. You can actually choose which one you want to go for, small, medium, or large, doesn't matter. I'm gonna go for medium again. Add a widget. Just like widgetsmith, I'm gonna click it, do edit widget, go to list, and then I'm gonna click schedule because I want the schedule reminder on my phone. Click schedule, and then it's gonna show up like this. So you can actually click it, edit home screen. You can actually change the location as well. If you want this photo on the top, so now you have all the reminders, time, and the cute rabbit photo as well. Now, how do you change the icons for each apps? For this one, you need an app called Shortcuts. So Shortcuts look like this. After downloading that, open Shortcuts. Click the plus icon on the top right. Add action, scripting, and then open app. Now you click choose. So you're gonna choose the app for the icon. So if you click on the icon, which app do you want it to open to? So let's go for YouTube. I want it to open YouTube. And then click this three dots on the top. And then you just add your shortcut's name. Just do whatever. It doesn't really matter. And now, add to home screen. And here, basically this name is how it's gonna show on the home screen. So unlike the actual name, let's say I wanna add YouTube and then the smiley face, or like YouTube and heart. Now I'm gonna click on the icon, select photo, and then I'm gonna select the photo that I want as the YouTube icon. Let's say I wanna add this photo of my dog, choose, and it's gonna show up like this on your home screen. Click add, and it's added. If I go onto home screen, it's added right here, my dog, and it's YouTube. One thing that's a bit frustrating for this feature is that once you click it, it goes on to like this. Basically, it's not leading you straight to YouTube. It goes to Shortcuts first, and then the Shortcuts leads you to YouTube. So I don't really recommend setting it up for an app that you might be rushed when you're using it. For example, let's say you have to take a picture of something very quickly, but if you set it up like this for the camera, then it's gonna take a bit of longer time to load the camera up. So I don't really recommend that, but it's your choice. So again, you can have totally different setup than what I have. Play around, do whatever you want, depending on what kind of style you have. If you continued watching my videos until here, congratulations, because I'm actually gonna give you some tips for decorating. A lot of people ask me, how do you get those aesthetic pictures for the widgets and for your Instagram and everything? So what I do is basically, you know, for the music, I have this cute little icons right here, Zoom. And also, if you look at it closely, I have different fonts. Listen, Canada Post right here. So I'm gonna teach you how to do that. Click the three dots again, do it at YouTube, and then I'm just gonna set it up as new one. And then add to home screen. All right, so let's say I wanna set YouTube as a cute different font. What I do is I usually just type cute font generator. It'll give you a bunch of these generator. You can choose whatever you want. If there's copy and paste written on it, that's the best one. So I'm gonna click Instagram fonts generator. And then because it's the YouTube app, I'm gonna say YouTube. And it's gonna show me how YouTube is written as a different font right here. Let's say I'm gonna go for this one right here. Copy, I'm gonna paste that. Voila. So how to get those pretty PNG looking icons, aesthetic PNG. And you'll be able to see a bunch of different PNG right here. Or you can go onto like apps like Pinterest and then find one that you like. I'm just gonna go for Sandylion. There's this cute cat sticker picture. I'm gonna add that to photos. Select cat photo and then adjust the size as how I want. Do it like that. Choose, and this is how it's added. Add, done, and now it's totally done. There's an icon for YouTube, but let's say I don't want that anymore, delete that. And now I have this cute YouTube icon as the font that I want and the icon that I want. And then the last one, if you look at my reminders tab, I have this cute twinkly icon and this emoji thing, right? Sparkle, copy, paste, symbols. And then you'll be able to see fancy sparkles and symbols right here. Nature mood or whatever, and a bunch of stars. So let's say I want the stars. I do that, copy, and then you just add that to the reminders tab or the name for your icon or whatever. So yeah, basically that's how I get my photos and fonts. I know that a lot of you guys asked me about my wallpaper. Well, basically my wallpaper, I took a picture of the NCT album that I have. That's how I got my wallpaper. I just like took a photo of it. I just really like this page, so I don't think you guys can like get it from online unless someone scanned it, but that's how I got mine. So you can search for an aesthetic wallpaper or take a picture of something that you want as your wallpaper, like me. So yeah, that's what you can do. Alright guys, so that is it for my widget tutorial. I hope this helped. I hope it wasn't really confusing. I tried to do my best explaining it clear and concise. If you have any additional questions, feel free to comment down below as well. Please make sure to subscribe and like, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye!